has made herself to be faithful to this ministry. And the type of pastor I am, I believe in faithfulness over anything. I believe in faithfulness over any and everything. Amen. And in 4 years, she has been faithful. She's here not to be the best, but she's here because she has been faithful. Amen. And that's what we thank God for. Amen. So I ask that you not sit in seats of judgment. It is not easy to preach to y'all. I know. Amen. So let's make sure that we talk back to the preacher. Amen. Because preaching is dialogue, not monologue. Amen. So we want to encourage her. She has a word, y'all. She has a word. Amen. And the praise team is going to minister because this is her service and she wanted y'all to sing. That's what I love, the creativity. You know, if she would have got up here with some props, I wouldn't have been surprised because y'all know how we roll. But she wanted the atmosphere to be set in her own way. Amen. So the praise team is going to minister. And listen, after the praise team, I ask that you rise to your feet and receive the speaker of the day, Sister LaStar Rose, who will minister the uncompromising word of the Lord. Out of her mouth, God is going to use her mightily. Stretch your hand to her and say, LaStar, preach the word. We will receive. Amen. Come on and put those hands together.
Come on, if y'all are ready to lift up the name of Jesus, as we prepare and make this atmosphere conducive for the word of God that's about to come forth. Come on, everybody, get on your feet. Let's praise God. Come on. Clap your hands like this. We give you glory, God. We give you the praise because you are worthy. Hallelujah, God. Somebody open up your mouth right here and shout. Come on. We give you glory, Father. Say, oh.
You are my strength.
You're my
joyful occasion. Thank you, God, for all that you have done. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. So good morning to you all. Good morning. I just love every one of you. Giving glory to God, I just want to first thank him for this very moment, for seeing it fit to grant me his grace and mercy to stand before you today. He could have chosen anyone else, but he saw fit to provide me with this opportunity to express my love to him in this avenue. So for that reason alone, I tell him thank you. Amen. Amen. Giving honor to my pastor and first lady for seeing in me what I could not see in myself, for helping me to cultivate the gift that I have, for God divinely placing them in my life for such a pivotal point in my life. I'm so grateful and I love you both. To my mama, my beautiful ray of sunshine, my twin, traveling all the way from Michigan. She said, come hell or high water, she was gonna be here today. So for that, I give God praise, hallelujah. For my family, if you guys would just wave and let everybody know that you're here from Georgia, from Michigan, I love y'all. Thank you. Thank you. To all of you, my church family, my home away from home, I thank you all for loving me the way that you have. God put me right here because he knew that you guys would love me like you do. You know, being so far away from my family, it's really hard, but you guys have made it so worth it. You guys have made it bearable, so thank you. Thank you all for loving me the way that you have. Amen. Let's jump right into the word. We're going to come from Esther chapter 4, verse 14, and it reads as thus, if you keep quiet now, help and freedom for the Jews will come from another place. But you and your father's family will die. And who knows, maybe you have been chosen to be queen for such a time as this. Dear gracious and kind Father, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise, Lord God, for this very moment. Lord God, I ask that you decrease in me, Father, and that you let your spirit reign, Lord God. Give us permission for proficiency to speak right now in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we call on you right now. Lord God, open up our hearts, open up our minds, open up our ears, Father, so that we can leave changed on today. Allow this atmosphere, Father, to break chains, Lord God, to bring healing, Father, to bring deliverance. Lord God, we thank you, we give you glory, and we magnify your name. And it's in your name that we pray and we thank you. Amen. If I had to choose a topic for today, I would ask you to look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you have been chosen for this very moment. Now, chosen is defined as having been selected as the best or more appropriate. Another definition of chosen, which happens to be my favorite, is one who is the object of choice or divine favor. You see, to be chosen to fulfill an assignment can bring a person great joy or great sorrow, depending on the task at hand. How many of us have been in a position where something really needs to be said, or something is pulling desperately on our hearts, but you found yourself with your mouth tightly zipped due to the fear of being misunderstood? Your family and friends might look at you differently, or say you're starting to act different, or because you have gotten so comfortable in the position that you're in, you fear that you may lose it. So that's basically what's going on with Esther in this particular passage. Esther was of Jewish descent, but because of her youth and her astounding beauty, she was appointed to be the queen of Persia. Because being a Jew was considered, you know, being of lower status in comparison to the people of Persia, her cousin Mordecai advised her to keep her Jewish nationality a secret. Now see, the king's right-hand man, Haman, demanded respect from all the king's other servants and advisors. You know, it stated that they bowed down to him, and they also worshiped him. However, this man named Mordecai refused to break his commitment to God by bowing down to an idol god, or in this case, a person of great authority. Now, with Mordecai's refusal to pay homage to Haman, Haman grew very upset and ordered not only for Mordecai to die, but for all the Jews in the country to die. Now, since Mordecai's cousin was now the queen, he went to her. He asked her for help, and she told him no. You know, sometimes we can get promoted and we start acting brand new on folks. It's so important for us to remember that the same way somebody helped us, we have the power and we have the responsibility to help others in need regardless to our status, right? Now find somebody, look them eyeball to eyeball and say, neighbor, will you help me? You see, no one was allowed to go to the king unless they were personally called by him. Otherwise, they were sentenced to death. But Mordecai quickly put Esther in her place, and he told her, maybe you have been chosen for this time. Now, what does he mean by that? Why did he tell her that? Esther's status gave her the ability to advocate for her people, the people that she loved, the people that she was closest to. And God specifically ordered her steps to be able to go to the king on the behalf of her family who were Jewish. How many of you believe that God has predestined you to do great things, to be able to be a blessing to others? He has chosen you to be a part of his royal priesthood. It is necessary for us to line up with the will of our lives, with his will for our lives. You know, the enemy tries to give us reasons why we should hold off or why we should be discouraged and not do it at all. I'm going to tell you some things that the devil says to discourage us. Number one, you got to get yourself right first, girl. Got to get yourself right. You ain't living right. You see, John 15 and 16 says, you didn't choose me, I chose you. I appointed you to go and produce lasting fruit, so the Father will give you whatever you ask for by using my name. John 15, Jesus is telling us, or using the grapevine to describe how we are connected to him. You see, he is the true vine. He says that we are the garden and God is the gardener. He goes on to say that God cuts off anything and any branches that do not produce life. It is our responsibility to be fruitful. Amen? Just be fruitful. And once you are in Christ, God cuts away those things that do not produce life. And what does he mean? You do not have to be perfect to have a relationship with God. You do not have to be perfect. You see, he's the perfecter. He specializes in using imperfect people to do perfect things in his perfect place and his perfect timing. Now, let me say that again, because I want to make sure that you all got it, okay? He specializes in using imperfect people to do perfect things in his perfect place and his perfect timing. Y'all want me to give you some proof? Let me give you some proof. Moses, Exodus 4 and 10, and it says, but Moses pleaded to the Lord, oh Lord, I am not very good with my words, and I have never been, and I am not now, even though you have spoken to me. I get tongue-tied, and my words get tangled. And the Lord asked Moses, who makes a person's mouth? Who decides whether or not a person speaks, whether or not he hears, or whether or not he sees? Is it not I, says the Lord? Now go ahead, and I'll be with you as you speak, and I will instruct you what to say. Amen. You see, Moses gave God every excuse in the book with his initial encounter. Moses told God he couldn't do it because he had a speech impediment, but God still made him go. But he also gave him assistance. He sent Aaron to help him. He always makes a way. God will never send you to do anything without giving you exactly what you need to have to get the job done. Aren't you glad that you serve a God who can make a way out of no way? Who can provide for you when you are feeling like you are all the way down to your last? Who can speak on your behalf? And who can do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ever imagine? Why don't you open up your mouth and tell God, thank you. Thank you, God. Another thing the devil says to make us think that we're incompetent, you've made too many mistakes. You made too many mistakes in your past. God can't use you. Revelations 21:5 says that the one who was sitting on the throne looked down and said, look, I'm making all things new. You see, once you let him in, he'll make everything new. Your thought process, your desires, your habits. Once you let him in, it starts there. It starts in your heart and it starts in your mind. Romans 12:1 says that it all begins with the transforming and the renewing of your mind, right? You have already been forgiven. And God sent his one and only son for the sole purpose of dying so that you can live again. Regardless to how much we've messed up, he is there waiting for you. His forgiveness and his love are endless. The magnitude of love that God has for you supersedes any mistake that you have made, any lie that you have told, and any unforgiveness that you are harboring in your heart. He knows you inside and out. He knows you. Lastly, the devil tells us, you've had too many hardships in life. Just give up. Just give up. Romans 5:3-5 tells us that we ought to rejoice when we go through struggles, when we go through hard times, because these moments help us to build our endurance, which helps develop character, and character strengthens our hope of salvation. Now, right there, we should be happy. We should be happy when we go through hard times and not give up, because we gotta go through the process. The good things and the bad things. But now we have hope. And my word tells me that the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be compared to the glory that shall be revealed in us. And if we go down just a little bit further, the word tells us that all things work together for the good of those that love the Lord and that are called according to his purpose. And he says all things, not some things, not the good things, not just the bad things, but all things work together for the good of those that love the Lord and are called. And another word for called is chosen. You have been chosen for such a time as this. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, Esther didn't understand. She didn't understand her position. She didn't understand her position, and she quickly began to comprehend the assignment, and she followed through. Now, not only did she follow through, but she strategically fasted and prayed. And because of this divine assignment of being chosen, not only was she able to save Mordecai, not only was she able to save her family, not only was she able to save her people, but she saved a multitude of Jewish people. Hallelujah. Why don't you give God glory? Now, I don't know what you are going through at this very moment, but I want you to know that God will never put more on you than what you can handle. He wants us to rely solely on him, and the only way that we can make it is if we do so, not by our own strength, but by the power of the Holy Spirit. He's designed this specific situation for you so that you can live through it, so that you can build through it, and not just for you, but so that you can help the next person through it. You see, the things that we go through are not for us. It's to divinely equip us to handle the assignment that is on our life. I am here to encourage you today, to let you know that after what you have done, where you have been, or what you are currently doing, that God has still chosen you. Each and every person in this room has a divine assignment, regardless to what the devil may say, what your friends may say, what your family may say, or what you say about yourself. God wants to use you. And I want you to hear me. I need you to hear what I'm saying. And I'm going to tell you a story about a little girl. I know a little girl who gave her life to Christ about the age 7, 8. You know, and she really loved him. She prayed all the time. She was giving her family members scriptures. When people passed away, she was taking them the Bible. Here, read this. You know, and tragedy kind of struck. Not too bad. She was harmed by somebody that was very close to her at a young age. But you see, she didn't let that stop her either. She continued to love the Lord. She continued to allow her to use him. She continued to pray. And at the age of 16, she decided, you know, I'm gonna wait on the Lord. I'm going to serve him. You know, I'm going to save myself for marriage. And then she met a man. How many of you guys know that soul ties are real? Soul ties are real. And she reneged on that promise to God because she just knew that this was the man that she was going to be with for the rest of her life. You know, and against her mother's wishes, against her mother's advice, against her mother's love, she moved out of state with this man. And, you know, she thought they were going to progress. They were going to move on, you know. And he didn't marry her. She was really upset about it, too. And then, you know, she began to backslide. She began to backslide, and then she met a beautiful couple at work one day, and they began to reintroduce her to the love of God. How many people know that somewhere, somebody is praying for you? Somebody is praying for you. And then she got pregnant out of wedlock. So now she's thinking, no, God really can't use me now. Now I really need to marry this man. And she married him against what God told her to do. And in the midst of that situation, although she was disobedient to God, how many of you know that God will still turn your disobedience around and use it so that you can minister to other people? Amen? That's when God really began to show himself in her life. He began to speak to her more often. She was being abused mentally, physically, emotionally, held away from her family. She never gave up on God. And one day at a women's revival, she heard a word. And that word helped deliver her and set her free. Amen. So now she's divorced. She's a single mom. God can't use her. A few years pass. She's now a college graduate. She is a single mother, but she's doing very well. She loves the Lord with all her heart. And on today, that woman, that imperfect woman, stands before you, giving God glory for everything that he has done. If God can use me, a broken woman, a disobedient woman, a scared woman, an abused woman, a fornicating woman, he can use you. He can most certainly use you. So don't you let anything that anyone has to say stop you from doing what it is that you know that God has called you to do. Amen. Is there anyone today that can stand with me and give God a yes? He is waiting on you with his arms wide open. Just tell him, thank you. Thank you for choosing me. Thank you for my bad times. Thank you for my struggles. Thank you for loving me enough to give me this opportunity. We don't know the day or the hours that our souls will be judged for the decisions that we have made here on earth. It won't be an easy yes, but he is ready to help you. He is ready to lead you, and he is ready to give you the desires of your heart. I just want you to stand with me on today. Stand with me on today and just pray to God right now. There may be someone in the room who does not know the Lord, and I ask that you all just bow your heads. There may be someone in the room who does not know the Lord, and I want to pray the sinner's prayer with you. If you desire salvation on today, just lift your hands in the air if that is you. You don't have to come up and draw a scene. Just lift your hands. And after service, one of our ministers will be ready to pray with you. Dear God, I am a sinner and I need your forgiveness. I believe that Jesus Christ died in my place, paying a penalty for my sins. I am willing right now to turn from my sins and accept Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior. I commit myself to you, and I ask you that you send the Holy Spirit in my life to fill me and to take control and to help me become the kind of person that you want me to be. Thank you for loving me. Dear gracious and kind Father, we thank you for what has taken place on today. We thank you, Lord God, for your grace and your mercy. We thank you for your protection. Lord God, we thank you, Father, that somebody's heart has been pierced on this morning, that somebody's life has been changed. Lord God, I ask that you just continue to hold them in your arms, Lord God. Remind them that you love them despite of what they are going through, despite of what they've done, despite of the lies that they've told, the places they have been and the people they have been with. Lord, remind them of your love. Remind them that they have been chosen divinely by you, oh God, and that you love them more than what anybody can, more than anybody can imagine. Lord God, we thank you and we give you glory. Lord, I thank you for using me, Lord God, as your willing vessel. Lord God, I ask that you continue to cover the people under the sound of my voice. Go with them and be with them right now, Father. Make the crooked places straight and make the dark places light for them. Open up their eyes and ears so that they can see you and see you truly. And it is in your name that we pray and thank you. Amen.
Come on, y'all, put those hands together and bless the name of the Lord. Amen. As we get in place, amen. As we get in place, it's a sweet spirit. And just, I don't think you heard it, but just slip your hand up and just talk to God. Maybe you ain't said nothing to him all week. And I love what she said. Some of us just need to tell him yes. You don't even have to know what you're saying yes to, but just say yes, Lord, to your will, to your way. Come on, any worshipers in the house? Come on, slip those hands up. Come on, let's sing a little bit of that. Come on, our Father.
Our Father, all of heaven roars your name. Sing louder. Let this place erupt with praise. Can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching earth. The sound of heaven touching earth. Our Father, all of heaven roars your name. Sing louder.
Come on, let this praise.
Let this place erupt with praise. Can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching earth.
Whoa. Amen. Now we want to officially consecrate LaStar as a Baptist minister in the Lord's church. Amen. We believe in anointing. We believe in anointing the head, the hands, and the feet of those who have answered the call of God. Amen. She has demonstrated her gift. And we all have approved that she is called. Amen. And we will now charge her with the task. We will charge her with the assignment that she will walk worthy of the vocation wherewith she has been called.
The scripture tells us in 1 Timothy chapter 4, verses 9 through 16, this is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptance. For therefore we both labor and suffer reproach, because we trust in the living God, who is no man despised, who is the Savior of all men, especially of those that believe. These things command and teach. Let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of the believers in the word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity. Till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. Neglect not the gift that is in thee, which was given thee by prophecy, with the laying on of the hands. Meditate upon these things. Give thyself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear to all. Take heed unto thyself and unto doctrine. Continue in them, for in doing this thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee. We will now have some words from Minister Robin Hanna.
Question, Star. Do you accept the Bible of God, inspired, infallible, inerrant, immutable, indestructible, and indispensable word? Answer, I do. The Lord being my helper. Okay. Question for you. Do you understand the requirements, the responsibilities, and the realities that you're about to be placed upon you by being licensed and set apart as an ambassador of the Lord Jesus Christ? Answer. To the Lord being my helper. Question. Are you ready and willing to accept and assume the responsibility to pursue, preach, and practice God's word with boldness, to minister to the needs of those whom you are sent without partiality, and give yourself sacrificially and without reverse to the edification, and equipping the body of Christ? Answer, I do, and the Lord being my helper. And I pass this charge on to Elder Blue.
Will you endeavor to be diligent in studying of the word of God's word, instant and faithful in prayer, an example in Christian purity and discipline before your people in the community, in order that your life may be a worthy Christian example, and that upon your ministry the blessing of God may rest? Answer, I will, the Lord being my helper. Recognizing the sacred responsibility of your call and aware of your human weakness, will you seek the leadership and empowerment of the Holy Spirit in order that you may faithfully minister of him who has called you? Answer, I will, the Lord being my helper. I now turn this mic into the hands of Minister Sherry Sims.
Amen. I charge you to pursue the word of God. Paul charged Timothy, till I come, give attendance to reading and exhortation, to doctrine. Meditate upon these things, given thyself wholly to him, unto them, that they profiting may appear to all. And that is from 1 Timothy 4, 12 and 15. Paul further charges Timothy to study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. 2 Timothy 2, 15. And I give this now to Minister Levette.
I charge you to practice the word of God. Paul affirms that when he says in 1 Timothy 4 and 12, let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, watch what you say, in charity, in spirit, in faith, and in purity. I'll now pass this to Elder Crawford. Sorry. Minister Drew.
Star. just excited about the opportunity to witness you coming and being used by the Lord today. I charge you to preach the word of God. Paul's final instruction to Timothy was, I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing in his kingdom. Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth and shall be turned unto fables. But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry.
We will now to ask that all the ministers come down, as well as the MITs, to gather around our pastor, where we will do the prayer of ordination. We will have our prayer by our very own First Lady, Lady Leah McNair.
Would you pray with us as we anoint God's woman servant as she goes forth to do the work of the ministry? Father, we thank you. We thank you for what our eyes have seen and what our ears have heard. We thank you that as her shepherd pours the oil, that it is just as Samuel poured the oil upon the head of David. Father, we thank you that you are making full proof of her ministry today. Lord, even before she was in her mother's womb, you anointed her for this day, this moment, this second, this hour. And so now, Lord, fill her with your glory. Fill her cup and let it overflow, God. Now we thank you that as the oil is poured from the head down, so now a fresh oil is resting upon LaStar Rose today. God, we thank you that her mouth has been anointed to preach the word of God without compromise. God, we thank you that she shall go forth with boldness and power and authority. She shall speak with clarity wherever you send her. Lord, whatever you tell her to say, she will say. Whatever you tell her to do, she will do. God, now give her a constant yes in her spirit. Yes, Lord, to your will. Yes, to your way. I am your servant today. God, give her a yes. And so now, Lord, as the oil is poured, God, we thank you that there is a hedge around her and no weapon that is formed against her shall prosper. Satan, we know you are upset because she answered the call, but you are already defeated. She walks in victory. And so now, Lord, we thank you that she shall be instant in season and out of season. She'll preach when they want to hear. She'll preach when they don't want to hear. She'll preach when they like it. She'll preach when they don't like it. Lord, this new season, this new moment, this new day, we thank you for it. Thank you for all the lives that she will touch. Thank you for all the souls that she will save. Thank you for those that will be delivered by the laying on of her hands. Thank you, Lord, that our eyes have not yet seen, our ears have not yet heard, neither has it entered into the heart of man, the things you have prepared for LaStar Rose. But God, we give you praise for it. We praise you right now with the fruit of our lips. We give you glory, God, with the fruit of our lips, because we know the best has yet to be seen. And so God, we send her forth to do the work of the one that has sent her. In the name of Jesus, we pray and we thank you. Amen. Somebody help me give the Lord glory. Come on, let's give him glory. He's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our adoration. Come on, her hands are lifted. Why don't we lift our hands?
Let all the other names fade away.
Let all the other names fade away.
Let all the other names fade away. Until there's only you, let all the other names fade away. Jesus, take your place. Jesus, take your place.
Let all the other names
fade away.
Let all the other names.
Let all the other names fade away. Until there's only you. Let all the other names fade away. Jesus, take your place.
Take your place,
Jesus.
Jesus,
take your place.
Stand and be strong. Let all the other
names fade away.
pray.
Let all the other names fade away.
Come on, let's the star bless them a little bit.
Let all the other names fade away.
Let's give her a moment to bless him.
Jesus, take your place. Jesus, take your place. Yeah. All the other names fade away. Let all the other names fade away.
Come on, somebody shout hallelujah. Come on and put those hands together and bless the name of the Lord. Come on, y'all can do better than put those hands and bless the name of the Lord. Come on, Mario, spirit break out.
Spirit break out.
Hallelujah. Come on, tear our walls down.
Tear our walls down. Woo.
Spirit break out.
Spirit break out.
Today we witness heaven come down. Hallelujah.
Heaven come down.
Amen. Amen. Listen, listen, our time is ended, but we thank God for your patience. We thank you for you being a witness to confirm what the Lord has done. And watch this, what the Lord will continue to do. Because he who has began a good work shall perform it. When you look at that word, that means he will continue a good work. He does nothing good and stops being good. He will continue to do a good work. LaStar, faithfulness got you here. And faithfulness is going to get you till tomorrow, to years to come. Be faithful to the Lord. And if you be faithful over the little, he'll make you ruler over many. Amen. We celebrate you today.
LaStar, it is our honor and privilege as your pastor and your first lady and your entire church family, Emmanuel Baptist Church, it is our honor to present you this certificate of license. This is to certify that Minister LaStar Rose, as one who has given evidence of the call by God into ministry as a minister and was licensed to function in ministry as the opportunity may be presented and to exercise God-given gifts in ministry by Senior Pastor P. Michael McNair, Emmanuel Baptist Church, on the 19th day of March, 2017. Come on, y'all. Let's love on her. Let's love on our LaStar. Come on, let's love on her.
Amen. Amen. Thank you guys so much. Let's stand to our feet as we prepare to dismiss. And those who want to come and greet LaStar and just love on her, celebrate her. Amen. Put something in her hand. The Bible says he who receives a prophet receives a prophet's reward. One of the ways you show you receive someone is by being a blessing to them. Amen. And we thank God for her family that came from Michigan and Georgia. Come on, Emmanuel. Let's thank God for them. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much. And as she said, we have been her family away from family. We have loved her. She has sisters and brothers and mom and dads here in this church. And mom, we're going to continue to take good care of her. Amen. We love her just like our own. Amen. So we thank you guys for coming near and far. We pray for traveling mercies. Amen. All hearts and minds are clear. Father, we thank you for this opportunity for us to worship. God, we thank you for this opportunity for us to hear a word from one of your chosen, not just for the moment, but for the season, for the duration. God, we thank you for the assignment, the purpose, and the destiny over her life. God, we ask that you restore the virtue. Father, right now we pray a special hedge of protection all over her. God, as we know that once you release a word, God, it's the enemy's job to come, God, and not just try to take the word, but try to take the messenger. So, Father, we cover her now in the name of Jesus. God, we cover her family. We cover her child in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for everything that you're going to do in her life. Now, God, as we leave this place, but never from your presence, go with us and stand by us until we meet again. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Hug somebody, tell them I love you. I don't care what you say.